using dummy variables in a regression model in SPSS. In another video, we have created dummy variables for smoking status. Dummy variables identify non-smokers, former smokers, and smokers. We can include those dummy variables as predictors in a regression model, but we should always leave one dummy variable out, otherwise we cannot estimate the model. The dummy variable that we leave out is the reference group. Let's do a regression, a linear regression. We use the attitude towards smoking as the dependent variable, the outcome. We use exposure to an anti-smoking campaign as one of the predictors or independent variables. And then we have to select two out of the three dummy variables. Let's use the non-smokers as the reference group. They are represented by status 1. So we leave that one out and include status 2 and status 3. Now we probably want to have the confidence intervals as well. So let's select them in the statistics part and then paste, run. We get the usual output for a regression analysis, the model summary with R-square, the ANOVA table with the F-test. They're discussed in another video, so let's focus on the coefficients. Now we see that the exposure variable has a negative effect on the predicted attitude towards smoking, and now we come to the dummy variables. For dummy variables, don't interpret the standardized coefficients, the beta values. They are more or less meaningless for dummy variables. So let's stick to the unstandardized coefficients. If we have a look at coefficient for former smoker, we see that on average, former smokers have a more negative attitude towards smoking than non-smokers. And the difference is substantial. It's 2.8 on a 10-point scale. That's a lot. The difference is also statistically significant. The t-test is highly significant with a p-value below 0.001. The confidence interval tells us that the average difference between former smokers and non-smokers in the population is between 3.5 and 2 points on the attitude towards smoking scale. For the other dummy variable, identifying the smokers, we see that there is a very small difference between smokers and non-smokers. Smokers have a slightly more negative attitude towards smoking, 0.2. But this difference is too small to be statistically significant in the current sample. P-value is 0.53, well above 0.05. And this is how we use dummy variables in regression analysis.